Did you know that Radio Shack is still in business? I think a lot of people have the mistaken notion that they went out of business in 2017. Well, they did go through bankruptcy and they did close most of their stores, but it was actually Chapter 11 bankruptcy which allowed them to stay in business. And they're still selling items online on Amazon and through the RadioShack.com website. And apparently they even still have a couple hundred independently owned stores. So I bought this from RadioShack on Amazon.com. You can see it was shipped by them. If I open it up, here's the packing slip from RadioShack. I ordered it on September 3rd. They shipped it out the same day and it arrived 2 days later. You can see it's a digital AM/FM pocket radio. It cost $24 plus shipping. The shipping was $5. And here it is. And this is a brand new item. It's not old stock from a couple years ago that they're still selling off, because there's the date code on the bottom. It's the same style they've been using for many decades, since at least the 70s. It's the month, then the letter A, and then the year. So this was made in July 2020. Distributed by General Wireless, which is the company who currently owns Radio Shack. And it still has their catalog number, 120-1849. So there it is, a little digital pocket radio with auto-scan digital tuning, 40 presets, works with wired stereo headphones or earbuds. None are included, which is okay, because usually with these things, if they include earbuds, they're usually pretty awful anyway. Soft FM antenna built into the wrist strap. That's unusual. So if you're not using headphones and you just want to listen to the built-in speaker, it uses the wrist strap as the antenna. And the battery should last for 50 hours of listening time, and you get a 1 year warranty. So here's the radio itself. Feels kind of lightweight, but it doesn't have any batteries in it yet. And I can peel off the protective film on the LCD. And one thing I like about this is that, unlike some of the Radicus radios I reviewed, separate buttons for tuning and volume on the sides. So you get volume up and down on this side and tuning up and down on this side. On the top is the stereo headphone jack, the 3-volt DC power input, which you're probably not going to be using on this kind of radio, power button, and there's the wrist strap, and you can just about see the wire that's attached to it, allowing you to use the wrist strap as the FM antenna. So I just put in some batteries, and there's the clock. That's the sleep timer, 90 minutes on 87.5. Well, those are the presets.
And they have to keep tables at least 6 feet apart. Pepe Lopez runs the Spanish restaurant Don Lopez in Newark's Ironbound District. His 350-seat banquet hall will remain mostly empty under the guidelines, but he says...
That's the maximum volume. Doesn't get that loud with the built-in speaker. So there's a local AM station tuned in. It's actually not a massive difference in sound quality between AM and FM through the built-in speaker. That's supposed to be Twist and Shout by the Beatles, but did you hear the problem there? You could hardly hear the vocals. And this is a mono AM station, so what I think happened is that they're only playing one channel, because this song, if you listen to it in stereo, one channel has the vocals, the other channel has all the instruments. And we're only hearing the channel with the instruments. This is 770 WABC in New York City. And they're playing music because Cousin Brucie, the legendary New York City area DJ, has returned to this station for a Saturday night show from 6 to 9 p.m. Eastern Time. He used to be on satellite radio, but now he's on WABC.
Shaking it up there all over the nation. Hey, speaking of shaking it up, they're shaking up all kinds of good stuff at that birthday party for Cousin John. Hey, John and Margo, everybody at the party, thank you so much. John, especially you and Margo, for taking such good care of Cousin Brucie.
She's Venus in blue jeans, Mona Lisa with a
At least on this song, the vocals are correct, so it's either a mono recording or they're actually playing it correctly. This is 1510 WMEX from Boston. Now it's called MeTV Music. It's an oldies, classic hits kind of station run by MeTV. I know in Chicago they have an FM, actually it's a Channel 6 TV signal that's acting as an FM signal called MeTV FM. Now they're on AM in Boston.
WMEX, I'm Jake Goodman.
It's MeTV Music all night.
1510 WMEX. So it's good to hear music on AM radio again. When's the last time, if ever, you heard the Pet Shop Boys on AM radio? I just wish this thing wouldn't keep defaulting to the clock when you're listening to the radio. I mean, it's fine that it has a clock when it's turned off, but when it's turned on, it really should prioritize the radio frequency.
Middletown, there you go, rocking out with some AC/DC right here on Jersey's Rat Radio 95.9, the Radish Boy Godsey.
There you can hear that the wrist strap is definitely acting as the FM antenna, because I can get two different stations on this channel depending on how I move the wrist strap. So the AM and FM reception on this radio is actually pretty good, and the sound quality on AM is surprisingly good, and the built-in speaker sounds about as good as what I expected. It's tinny, it doesn't get very loud, but it's clear and listenable. And you'd think it would sound even better when connected to a pair of external speakers like these Bose companion speakers. And it certainly can get a lot louder now. But it still sounds rather tinny. I know these are small speakers, but they're capable of very good bass response, and I'm just not getting that out of this radio, at least on AM. And a bigger problem that you may not be able to hear through the camcorder's microphone is that the output on this is wired out of phase. The result of this output being out of phase is that either if you're listening to headphones or if you have stereo speakers and you're positioned exactly between them, you get this weird effect where the sound sounds like it's coming from directly inside your head. It's very odd and disconcerting. To demonstrate the effect of this, first I'll play an audio sample I recorded directly from the headphone output of this radio. Then I'll play the same sample again, except with the audio phase corrected using an audio editor program on my computer. That was a test of the alarm function, so you can set it to a beeper or you can set it to come on and start playing the radio when the desired time is reached. And the clock also has a 24-hour mode if you prefer that format. And if it's dark and you want to check the time, just push any of the buttons and the display backlight will illuminate for 10 seconds. And speaking of the display, I noticed it has unused indicators for shortwave and weather band. So it would be nice if they introduced a model which did have those bands instead of just AM and FM. So I'm glad to see that Radio Shack is still in business and still selling new products. And on this little radio, I like the backlit display. I like the easy to use controls with separate buttons for volume, presets, and tuning. And it has good reception on both AM and FM. And the built-in speaker is nice to have. Even though it doesn't get that loud and it's pretty tinny, it is useful. And I like the very long battery life using standard AAA batteries. And everyone should have a battery-powered radio for use during emergencies. And something like this would be perfect for that purpose. I just wish the headphone output was in phase. And also wish the radio tuner would stay on the frequency display instead of always going back to the time when you have it turned on.
In my inspection, I've noticed some interesting new sources for foods, canned foods, things like that I've never noticed before. For example, Chinese tuna. I swear.
A very old man whinging. Good grief. No idea what this station is.
You'll see that some of your tuna comes from China. I never knew. Who knew that we get tuna from China? Then there was a package of spaghetti that I inspected, and they had a...
It really is just an old man whining. I've never heard anything like it.
The green, white, and blue of Italy. Where did that come from? It said product of ARE. Do you know where ARE is? ARE, A dot R dot E dot, is the United Arab Emirates. They're making spaghetti.